Hello my dear students, welcome for the online classes. Let us start with the geography lesson number 1, resources. Now the word resources is very familiar to you because children you have studied about natural resources. Now what do you mean by natural resources? The resources which we get from the nature. Now children, when I say the things which we get from the nature, suddenly which resources come to your mind? Air, water and sunlight. Now why air, water and sunlight are called resources? Because these resources, we make use of these resources and these resources satisfy our needs. So what do you mean by resources? Resources are the things which satisfy our need. Children, now water, electricity, vegetable, all these things have some common theme in them. All these resources we use in our day-to-day life. Children, a thing is said to be a resource when we make use of that resource. The thing which satisfy our daily needs, the things which satisfy the human needs are called resources. Now children, when we talk about water, electricity, vegetable, all these things have something in common. And what is that common? They provide us utility. Utility means what? The things which we use for our satisfaction. We utilize them. For example, children, air we breathe, water we drink, then we use water for so many purposes. So it has the utility. The resources which have the utility, which satisfies the human needs, is called the utility. So a resource has a utility also. So children, in this lesson we are going to study about the resources, types of resources, conserving resources. As children, this is the introductory part. Today I am going to explain you only about the resources. So children, is it clear what is resource? Resource is a thing which satisfy our need, and the best example I gave you is air, water and sunlight. These three natural resources satisfy our human needs. But children, only natural resources satisfy our human needs? No. There are many other resources also which we utilize in our daily life for satisfying our needs. So we need them and they satisfy our needs. Now we pay value for them. Children, when we talk about air, we don't have to pay for air. But children, there are some resources for which we have to pay for our utilization. For example, children, the water. Water is used as the hydroelectricity, and we are paying for the electricity. The electricity which we use, we have to pay for it. And the food which we get from the nature, directly or indirectly, we are paying value for these resources. So first of all, I want to explain you what is resource. Is it clear? A resource is a thing, anything which satisfy our needs. And children, when a resource is said to be when it is said that a resource has the utility, when we them in a proper way, and when the resource is utilized, it gets the value. So all the resources have the value, but when they are utilized and when they are converted into a proper manner, they get the value. Now children, the resources are available to us in abundance, but if these resources are converted into the finished products, if these resources are used in a proper way, then only we can say that the resources are utilized. And if they are utilized properly, equally, then only we can say that it has the value. And also children, the resources have the value, and the value is as a of total, economic and non-economic. Now children, economic means children, the mineral resources which we get from the earth crust, when we through the mining process, when the minerals like metal and all, it has the economic value. Without paying the minerals, we get the mineral resources from the earth crust, but children, when they are converted into finished products, they, when we utilize them, they get the value and we have to pay. So we, it is said that the minerals have the economic value. There are so many resources, not only minerals, but there are many resources which have the economic value. Non-economic means children, now for example, you have visited a hill station or any beautiful place. The scenery, the beauty of the nature also satisfy your need. It doesn't mean that it has the value. It is said that it is non-economic. Some of the resources are non-economic also. They also satisfy the human needs, because we feel fresh, we feel calm and fresh in that atmosphere. So it has satisfied our need. The scenery, the beauty of the nature also satisfy. But we don't pay for it because it is naturally available. So it is said that it is non-economic. So this is about the resources, utility and the value. Now the children, the last point is the time and the technology. Children, with the time and the technology, the resources changes its value also. Children, now the best example which I will give you is during this pandemic period, we are using these means, that is the online lectures, to teach you. Now children, since ancient time, the teaching learning process goes in the school with the teacher and the student. But as the time has changed and because of this pandemic situation, the technology the which we are using for your teaching, we are conversing you, we are communicating you with the help of this mobile and online teaching. So the time and technology, both the things are related for the utilization of the resources. Now children, we are trying to, with the time, the change in the time, we have used this new technology to satisfy the need of teaching learning process. So children, these three things, utility, value and time and technology, are interrelated with the resources. So children, today I have tried to explain you about the resources. So what are resources? The things which satisfy the human needs are called resources. And when we say that the resources are utilized, when they have the utility, when we utilize them in a proper way, it is said that they have the utility in them. Now, when the resource has a utility, it has the value in them. Means the resources have, all the resources have the value in them. But it depends on the economic and the non-economic. Because not only the natural resources, but there are so many resources which satisfy the human needs. Some of them have the economic value and some of them have the non-economic value. So children, I gave you here the example of minerals like metal, iron, copper, and here I gave you the example of the scenery beauty. Then the last point is the time and the technology. With the time, we use new technology to satisfy the human needs. During early period, early man, he was not aware of any new technology. He was a nomadic person. He used to move from one place to another in search of food. But as he discovered the fire, he moved towards the more development. Then the invention of the wheel again changed the life of the early man. Same way children, as the time passed, the new technologies are Today in this lecture, I want to explain you only about, I have tried to explain you about the resources. Thank you.